This video explains how to divide the FlexZone sensor cable into distinct detection zones and set unique alarm thresholds for them. In this video, we will look at a scenario with 225 meters, or 738 feet of sensor cable attached to a fence with a double swinging gate. The sensor cable is installed on both gate panels and runs underneath the gate area and conduit. We will divide the area into three zones, one for the gate and one for each side. Setting the initial zones and alarm threshold levels requires one person and usually takes about 20 minutes per processor side. Before you can configure the zones, you need to have a valid cable profile. In this tutorial, we will use the profile obtained during our previous tutorial. You will require a Windows laptop running the UCM software, a USB cable, and a large screwdriver. Connect your laptop to the FlexZone processor using the USB cable. Start the UCM software. The UCM software will automatically detect the FlexZone processor. Click Connect. Once the connection is established, select the cable side you want to configure. In this tutorial, we'll configure the zones for side A. Scroll down to show the cable profile and zone plot. In this tutorial, we've already profiled our cable. Let's examine the different sections of fence. First, at approximately 60 meters, the sensor cable is attached to the gate panel. At 75 meters, the sensor cable is routed into conduit underneath the gate area. At 90 meters, it exits the conduit and is installed on the second gate panel. At 110 meters, it continues along the fence. At 225 meters, the cable is terminated. It is important to note that at this stage, we are only working with approximate values. We will fine-tune the exact zone demarcation points during testing. Click the split button to add a new area. In the UCM, these areas are called segments. Each segment represents a physical length of sensor cable. Drag the boundary to the start of the gate area. Next, create another segment for the gate panel by clicking split again. Now create additional segments for the conduit, second gate panel, start of the regular fence, and the end of the sensor cable itself. Now that we have created the distinct segments, assign each one to a zone. Click on the area within the graph and enter a zone number. Leave the conduit segments blank, zone 0, and place both gate panels within the same zone, zone 2. At this time, you can also assign one of the FlexZone processor's 4 relay outputs to trigger whenever that zone goes into alarm. Make sure to leave the area after the end of the sensor cable in zone 0. Zone 0 is a special value. Segments set to zone 0 do not generate alarms. Notice that after we assign a zone to a segment, a red line for that zone appears. This is the alarm threshold value. Any disturbance that goes above this line will be considered an event and used to determine if an alarm condition is occurring. Adjust the alarm threshold line so that it is slightly below the profile line. Raise the line to make the zone less sensitive. Lower the line to make the zone more sensitive. Once we have set our initial zones and alarm threshold values, click the download button. At this point, you are ready to test your zone and alarm threshold values. Go to the edge of each zone area and use the screwdriver to tap the fence repeatedly until an alarm is generated. If the alarm is generated for the correct zone, leave it as it is. If it is not, drag the zone boundaries left or right as required until that part of the sensor cable reports the correct zone. Use the zoom buttons to zoom in and out as necessary. Make sure you download your changes to the processor each time to make them active before continuing with testing. Now that zones and alarm thresholds are configured, The processor will generate alarms when intrusion attempts are detected.